Hello and welcome to AzureWala YouTube channel. We are in part 70 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 117 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to discuss question number 118 and 119. You have an Azure subscription named Subscription 1. You create an Azure storage account named Contoso Storage, and then you create a file share named Data. Which UNC path should you include in a script that references files from the data file share? We are given with 8 options. We need to choose 3 options from these and fill in this answer area. So in first box we'll get storage name. So backslash will get the storage name. In our case storage name is Contoso Storage, so this will go in the first box. In the second box we'll get the service name, which is the file service dot core.windows.net. So file, the service name, and .core.windows.net. This would go in the second box. In the third box we will get the file share name, which is the data in our case. Therefore in the third box the data will come. Let's go to next question. Question 119. You have an Azure subscription that contains storage account named Account 1. You plan to upload the disk files of virtual machine to Account 1 from your on-premises network. The on-premises network uses a public IP address space of 131.107.1.0/24. You plan to use the disk files to provision an Azure virtual machine named VM1. VM1 will be attached to a virtual network named VNet1. VNet1 uses IP address space of 192.168.0.0/24. You need to configure account 1 to meet the following requirements. Requirement number 1, ensure that you can upload the disk files to account 1. Requirement number 2, ensure that you can attach the disks to VM1. Requirement number 3, prevent all other access to account 1. Which two actions should you perform? To understand this scenario, let's go to Azure portal and see how the network configuration can be optimized for this purpose on the storage account. We are in Azure portal. We'll go to resource group. Under the resource group RG1, we have AzureWala SA1 storage account. We'll go there, and under that storage account we'll go to networking blade. Under the networking blade, the first thing we need to select or secure the storage account is we will enable from selected virtual network and IP addresses. So that would be the first action. The second action would be that we will add an IP range to allow access from internet or on-premise network, and we will give the IP range. So this would be the second option, where we have provided IP range is 131.107.1.0. So we'll be using this one. So these are the first two actions. First one action is we'll enable from selected virtual network and IP addresses. Second option under this would be the firewall. Add IP range to allow access from internet or your on-premise network. So we'll give the address range for on-premise public IP. And the third action would be, however, it is only two actions being asked in this question. But the third action would be that we will be selecting virtual network and will provide the access to the subnet under that virtual network. So that's it for this question. Let's go back to the question. Option A. From the networking blade of account 1, select selected networks. Yes, this is the correct option here, because first action we need to restrict or limit the access to selected networks. Therefore, this would be the first action. Option B. From the networking blade of account 1, select allowed trusted Microsoft services. In our case, we are not accessing any Microsoft service to use this storage account. Therefore, this would not be applicable. Option C. From the networking blade of account 1, add the 131.107.1.0/24 IP address range. Yes, we need to add this IP address range in the firewall section of the networking blade to make sure that it is limited to this IP range only, which is the on-premise network. Therefore, option C is the correct answer. So option A is the correct answer, option C is the correct answer. For as we need only two actions here, therefore we are complete with the answers here. But let's see option D. Option D. From the networking blade of account 1, add VNet 1. If there would be on the question three actions, then we would select this next one is the third answer. But here only two actions are being asked. Therefore, we will have first two actions which we need to perform to secure this account. So third option, if needed, would be that we will be adding this virtual network and limiting to that virtual network only the storage account access. We will be limiting the storage account access to VNet 1 only. Option E. From the service endpoints blade of VNet 1, add a service endpoint. The addition of service endpoint to virtual network will not help our storage account to secure. Therefore, option E is not applicable. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you next video.